Welcome back, everybody, here to our second game of the day. And that is going to be NOTAI going up against Virtus Pro for the Russian DOTA 2 League. It is the lower bracket. It is the consolation final. And see who will play up against Team Dignitas in the grand final. That game will be coming up next. Will it be NOTAI? They're currently one game ahead on the back of a Coddle as well as PL. But Virtus Pro, they won't go down without a fight. Of course, that was proved during the last game. Let's jump ourselves in there right now and find out just what type of fight we're in store for. So NOTAI, this time will be over on the Dire side. First pick lies with them, and that means that Virtus Pro both the Radiant side, and of course with first pick being belonging to NOTAI, that means second pick belongs over to Virtus Pro. And they start off with a ban, so taking out Aki's Chem, taking out Admiral Bulldog's Nature's Prophet, and that means then that Wisp manages to slip through the pool. But in return for that one, means that Virtus Pro is able to get, if they want to, we can be looking down the lines of that Puck, we could be looking down the lines of Mag, Darkseer. There's just so many options, with Nyx and Batrider being the two being banned out, and there's no Invis Initiation. Illidan's still got his two big heroes too, which is the Nake as well as the Gyro. Both are available, because both also play by no Tidehunter in their lineups. So this really could be anybody's choice right now. So Lone Druid will be the pick-off as well as the Keeper of the Light. They block Admiral Bulldog's hero, and they also get their strength of the Keeper of the Light. And I wouldn't be surprised right now if Virtus Pro are thinking, well, if they're going to go Wisp early on, let's just go for a push strap. Let's just take down these outer towers, make it so they can't put out the aggressive warding. It is kind of like the downside about the Wisp. You can't global gank unless you have the global vision. Without that global vision, you can't just like jump in. So you need to put in very, very deep wards. And we'll look for it around the 20-minute mark in the game. We look to see where the warding is of NOTAI. So for guys who are tuning in right now inside the chat, make sure you remind me at the 20-minute mark that we make sure we check. We make sure we check where the wards are of NOTAI Hunter. Because I'm interested to see how deep they are. And if Virtus Pro do go, what I kind of feel like they're going to go like with a Lautrec pickup right now. 5 seconds. Don't need to expose the hand too much, just pick up the two supports. It means they're still missing possibly a number one hero. That could be a long lane, and normally KSI is the man that will take up the bear. So it could just be a long lane lone druid. See if he goes Admiral Bulldog's build with the poor man's shield instead of tangos, and then just double stack the wave and then just pull it down. So that's the other option. Or not. I think Admiral Bulldog is the only person I've seen go that building the Lone Druid. But NS, his choice is now. So, third pickup. He goes with the Nakes. So, we get the mass strength. Take out the number one position. Of course, you can always get the track later. But that now means that the supporters for S4, there's just so many to remove. I don't think he could take him out, all of them. So, instead, he just has to focus on the mid-banning. So, Queen of Pain, Puck to be removed. Yep, there goes the Puck. Anything which shuts down the mag. And Queen of Pain, it's actually quite easy, guys. When you think about the picks and the bans, because I know a lot of people have been talking about, like, well, I know a lot of people have been talking about my ability to actually read the game, which really is still not in-depth as much as I'd like it. But, hey, with discussions and everything else which I'm doing, we're getting there slowly, peoples. But when it comes to a draft, some things are just very, very obvious. And you can pick it out yourself. Like, you don't need to be a born genius at Dota 2 to at least understand the core concepts behind what happens. You say, okay, I have a mag in the solo mid. I want to spam from range. I want this to hit. And I also need to run a bottle. So, okay, I want to be free to do what I want to do with this one and not deal with a repositioning hero. So it's heroes like Mag who go, well, okay, Queen of Pain, repositioning hero, has some burst damage, she's going to turn it away against me, so she can evade my damage, and she'll also screw with my bottle by going with the sting. Puck, he's a different kettle of fish because he's got phase shift, costs no mana, he can evade not only a skewer, but also the shockwave harassment, so that's ended up wasted mana from Mag. All he gets is CS, which is still good, but he also wants to damage the hero at the same time. And then later on the game, you've got this Blink Dagger Silence jump in, and a mini stun teamfight controller, which goes straight against the mag. So you've got to take that hero out. The Lautrec is being banned out by S4, as very obvious too. You're looking at a lone druid and a keeper of the light. Lane control is already very, very strong here for Virtus Pro. They've got a lot of life points, and they've got a good area of effect damage that comes from that blast of keeper of the light with the Illuminate. And then you look for the extra coupling and say, well, okay, they can control the creep wave. What do they need now? They want to push before the bear's going to get demolished up, and demolish is a small buff up that lets them bring down the towers. Later in the game, gets a lot bigger when all the other auras start stacking up. But then you have a Lashrak Edict, and that would melt through the towers in a combination with the Nakes, who's already got himself up with that rage. And there's one controller for no Tidehunter. Actually, technically two. The Mag RP is the stable controller, and then you've got the slow from Gyrocopter's ultimate. While the damage isn't done, you've still got the extra slow. And there's the Queen of Pain, actually being banned out by NS. He takes out the Queen of Pain. Interesting. Most interesting. Takes out Darkseer, takes out the Bounty Hunter, and then he feels the Queen of Pain in a long lane would be a problem. Up against Nakes, though? I suppose there's no extra stunners. That's what we're looking for.
10 seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining.
Looks like I might have some company for the next game. For people out there too, because let's go the other issue that people have with me. Let's go the other issue that people have with me. The fact that I hardly ever have a co-commentator. I try and get him in as much as possible. I've actually got a conference called the Band of Casters, which is a collection of people who have casted me, who like casting with me, and have casted me in the past. So Sneaking is going to be coming in to join me for the next game. So he's basically just responded to the message which I pump out every day, saying, yeah, guys, who's free? Come and have a cast. He's like, yeah, I got time. Okay, that's cool. He's like, yeah, I'm in the grand final. I'm not casting the grand final. But he'll at least cast game number 3 with me. So we'll get his insight in before the grand final of Team Dignitas. So Rukimaru going to be the fourth pickup here from No Tidehunter. So they get their old combination. It's been a while since I've seen this. I say a while, probably about 3 weeks since I've seen No Tidehunter do this. So I don't think last time I saw it was actually during the Raycall EMS 1. And that was with the Wisp as well as the Rukimaru. So it's a really cool combination. Because most of the time, like with Rukimaru and Wisp, you're looking to blink yourself in with the tether. So you get the instant tether stun. Because you go for the backstab, so you jump to the opposite side of the hero, normally. Depending if they're running away or not. So you jump yourself in, then you get the stun, and that buys time for the full cloud to come up. So if you've got heroes like Queen of Pain or any kind of blinking style hero that wants to just run themselves away, they can't do so because the cloud is going to be coming in, and then you get silenced. It's like, well, okay, I can't move myself away from this one. I got tether stunned as well. Then Wisp comes in, and the buff's already going the way of the Rukimaru. So you get all this stuff just piling on top of each other, and you're like, well, okay, how do I get myself away from this? Then a mag comes in, there a gyro comes in, or a missile's there from gyro. It's an easy lockdown on someone you can find, and a hero like Nakes hates this kind of thing. He can't rage. He can't get his spell immunity. He can't get rid of these things. And that's the troublesome thing. That's the very, very troublesome thing for the Nakes right now. But they pick up a Rubik, which means we're looking at possibilities of stealing Wisp abilities. Even if it's just that ultimate to jump around the map, that's still fine. But we'll have that as well as having Mag Oldies to steal. Gyrocopter. You'd be looking to steal his ultimate out, if possible.
10 seconds.
Look for the snipe. And no time, need one last pickup, so one more support hero.
Storm Spirit is alive.
Okay, screw the support hero. Looks like support is going to be Gyro. I thought maybe they would have thrown S4 into that Gyro for the middle lane, but instead it's going to be a Storm Spirit now for Gyro, for S4. Loader will always take up his Rukimaru, and that puts Admiral Bulldog into the Magnus lane. But this also poses some more questions now. Magnus on a long lane up against Lone Druid, Rubik, and Keeper of the Light. It kind of feels like a first blood. And it kind of feels like there's going to be no other option for the Mag but to die. Just the feeling I'm getting. VP now missing mid-solo. So someone up against the Storm Spirit. They've already taken out the Queen of Pain. Would have been a fun pickup against Storm. And go for something else. Maybe try and bring that TA back. But up against a Gyro, you don't really want to do that. Rocket Barrage will take away basically your refraction charges almost instantly. So for guys who are also tuning in, I know a lot of you just jumped off the G1 League match. Welcome to the broadcast. Yeah, that's actually right. I keep tabs on everything else. Beastmaster will be the big up. So, okay, so that's going to be our mid-solo hero up against the Storm. Nice little roar to go through that BKB of Loader that will be coming up later as well. Yeah, but welcome to everyone who's just tuned in. If you have just tuned in, we're doing the Russian Dota 2 League. This is game number 2, No Tide versus Virtus Pro. No Tide under currently one game ahead. And this is the lower bracket final. The winner of this will face up in the grand final up against Team Dignitas. Now, we'll be joined in the next game as for a co-caster by Sneaking, which will be absolutely fantastic. Shout out to the man. And new member of Dignitas, maybe. If the rumors are to be true. If what was said on our panel last night was also true. Maybe we'll ask him directly when we bring him on. The return of Sneaking. All right. So let's look at our lanes. Admiral Bulldog, he's built to do it tough in the long lane. Stout Shield and a whole bunch of consumables. S4 will be the mid lane solo. That was EGM with Loader up on the top lane. So that's Wisp as well as Rikimaru, the Ratman, and Lee's Aki. Supporting is the Gyrocopter. And up against them, Virtus Pro, KSI is already making a move towards the top lane, but then again, so is the rest of the team. Eldon's leading the way. Stout Shield as well as a stick up on him, so... interesting build from Illidan to start off with a stick. Normally you're looking at... you're looking at that kind of build up against a Batrider or something like that, but in this scenario, he's up against EGM, Aki, and Loader, but with a stick, it means he has to remain up on this top lane. So NS as well as Arsart, they will stay up here on the top lane, which puts KSI onto a solo bot lane. It's going to be a lot nicer for a mag. A lot nicer, but he's still going to be harassed down by the bear. And puts Crazy in towards the middle lane as the Beastmaster. And that caps off our lineup. Loader, Aki, and EGM. They know there's going to be a ward around here somewhere, but they've got a sentry on Aki. Tether. Are they really thinking about contesting this first rune? Loader looks like he wants to, but they'd be really careful about pickups. If NS gets that telekinesis, you can really just throw him around by pulling him back. You can still throw up onto this, actually. That hill, I think you can't throw with Rubik. You can throw the other one. Illusion's in first. Minimal damage. EGM just tethers his way through. Doesn't take out the entire tree line. Just the end point of it. But it still opens up this area. And the funny thing is, with that tether, now this area is so much more visible for No Tide. They'll know the second that VP try and come to counter the pull. But the funny thing is, Aki doesn't know that there's a ward there. He doesn't know this little guy over on the side. So because of that, tether, pick up, throw down, EGM should get stunned from that one, but they'll stay close to NS. And it's just the supports playing around, but NS dropping down very, very low. Mantis on the tango to start with. How's our middle lane looking? So 2-0 up against a 5-2. S4 should really have a good time here in the middle lane up against Crazy until he gets his bottle. But then again, it's the same goes either way. Crazy, hey, S4. One more static remnant, and Crazy could be looking very, very dead. And they both will pop their salves already here in the middle lane. So at the end of the day, you could say assembly, even trade. But they both still come back in again before the salves are finished. Crazy gets attacked before he gets the full charge out of him. So KSI in the bottom lane up against Bulldog. Bears should win this one, 6-3. Up against a 2-0. And with an orb of venom already up on that bear, Admiral Bulldog will forever be harassed. At the same time, like all these lanes, it's going to be... I almost feel like missing First Blood right now. And not by choice. Because I know someone's going to overextend themselves even slightly. Once KSI hits that level 5, then you get the possibility of entangle on the bottom lane. Lone Druid, he can even skewer himself away from this one. But with the tank ability of the bear at level 5, they could already be looking to find some easy quick kills. And, well, 3-man push to go for the D wards. That Observer Ward just out of range of the Sentry Ward. And then Aki will come in after plant down his remaining Sentry Ward to clean it off. Tether, and they managed to find a couple. Quick pick up, it looks like NS will be the sacrificial lamb. They split themselves up, so NS will be chased through one way, while Loader being forced back out through the other. Another Brock Barrage, NS, there's no extra pickup. He's got a Fade Bolt, and there's last hit. First blood goes to EGM. Brock Barrage couldn't finish the job. But EGM with his range attack could. Goes up to level 2, so now we get spirits at the top lane as well. And there's down your counter warding. And just in time to go for a triple stack, but no, he starts to pull already. And then picks off the ward. So it won't be an extra stack up. TP support has returned though. So NS makes his way over, but it is no Tidehunter with the vision supremacy right now. Caught a blast or fly. Gets the kill on the Sentinel. A little bit of damage to Ahi on the edge. And then D ward. But again, the Sentry ward. Not going to get close enough to the Observer ward. So the vision still goes with no Tidehunter, even though they can't pull. But it will require them to buy another set of sentries. And that's going to take them some time. The courier for no Tide taking a trip down to the bottom lane. I'm assuming for a bottle for Admiral Bulldog, and I assume correctly. Bottle as well as boots bass for S4. And he's actually holding. He's holding the courier here. He could go for the 4-minute rune control. But it looks like he's not going to. Just puts the empty bottle back on the courier. I want to say chicken, but it's flying donkey. Most boringest courier in the world from no Tide. S4. Man. These guys really living life on the edge. Another static remnant. Crazy. Very, very low, but he still has 7 stick charges up his sleeve. Now up on the top lane. Looks like NS. Nice pickup. Throw back. It's a follow-up stun, but the spirits from Wisp. Slow to get the kill out in the supporter, but at the same time, Illidan picks off the other support. But Loader chasing down RSR, but Illidan going to get tether stunned up. No rage at the moment. And not going to be really worth it. Unless he needs to. He managed to basically thread the needle of EGM spirits before they timed out. But he wants to go back in again. Just force Loader off that lane at every single moment he possibly can. Roar now from Crazy onto S4. He's got axes right now too. No jump from Storms, but he's not level 6. He's taking up the creep wave. Crazy finishes the job. Got to get rid of this aggro. Get rid of this aggro. Can't do it. It becomes a 1-for-1 trade, but Beastmaster is the man who gets the kill to start with. So the advantage goes his way. And KSI is really shutting down Admiral Bulldog. 11 for 3 against a 25 for 11. This is controlled. This is fully controlled. And then up on the top lane, Illidan and SA, they're actually pretty close. 21 for 7 up against a 16 for 1. That's fine. Storm Spirit, 24 for 7. CS is good. 22 for 2. CS is still fine for Beastmaster. But the kill goes the way of Crazy. So advantage now goes the way of Virtus Pro in the middle lane too. So if you look over everything, you'd actually expect to be a little bit higher than that. You really do. For 5 minutes in, 750 experience difference as well as 0 gold. That's nothing. That is really, really nothing. Now, Bear's making a play. Admiral Bulldog already doesn't want to take the risk. He gets hit once and a possibility of getting entangled there. And then KSI would have kept just beating into him. I think also Admiral Bulldog realizes he can't get a kill on the bottom lane. I think all he wants is boots now. With this last creep, now he can afford boots. Buy boots from the side shop. Get some movement speed and also get him closer and closer to those arcanes. Yeah, there he goes, boots. Middle lane. My bad. Beastmaster again. Roar comes off cooldown and Storm Spirit's dead again. And a DD rune to go his way.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Things are falling apart for no Tide's mid lane. And Illidan just says, oh, sweet. Aki's out too far. Let's rage it. Coddle Blast as well. Extra damage. One more hit from Illidan. One more hit. The Beastmaster axes fly to try and snipe it out. At least ensure the kill, I should say. But not going to be possible. Illidan needs to life leech out a little bit more here. 4 heroes up on the top lane with a double damage on the Beastmaster. Still got a set of actors. Loader's going to feel very, very uncomfortable on this top lane. But at the same time, S4 feels very, very comfortable in the middle lane. Beastmaster rotated up, doesn't find a kill, came a little bit too late. Was not going to lend a roar, it's just axes. But the double damage just made him feel like he should have been there. Really felt like he should have been there. But at the end of the day, it would have been crazy enough if he picked up just a regeneration rune. It's like, ah, go back to mid. That would have been the easier thing. And would have been a lot more efficient for VP. But now you see him ahead in the gold. That's a little bit more. Yeah, that's kind of like what more of what I was thinking was the difference. Maybe the grass are just deceiving me. Guess that experience gain. Only the last minute and a half to 2. But it jumps up. S4, jump over, then Spirits come in with the Wisp and tether up, and Crazy, maybe with the Step 1 charges, lets off a Roar, and they're going to bring down, and yeah they do, the Wisp to take a fall, and S came with the perfect timing to go with the Telekinesis, but maybe there's enough, yeah, there's just enough mana for S4, quick jump up the hill, and he's basically blown all of his mana, but it's a Beastmaster for a Wisp. Well worth the trade. Well worth the trade. And all this game really feels like it is just trades. Again, more rune control. Bear Scouts at the bottom one. It could also be the other reason why Admiral Bulldog never even worried about checking the bottom rune. Realized he goes into the river. One is the choke point, and two, because the bear just goes in there and can pick up the rune right in front of his very eyes. All depends who can click faster.
Dire's middle tower is under attack.
Now TP bottom lane. So load up. They're looking for a change-up. Realize they've got to do something about KSI. It's getting way too fat. Phase Boots are already coming his way in a moment if he's able to find a little bit more farm time. And Loader, well, KSI in ultimate form. See if Loader does have enough damage to stop this, especially if that bear gets an entangle on Loader very early on. Admiral Bulldog going to use an RP for this one. Yeah, he will. RP's it up. No need for a smoke. He's going to use it anyway and then help. The axe to fly and KSI, the entangle, so you're looking for it. It goes an Admiral Bulldog, buys the space, quick Roar to kill him off. And Loader will look for the snipe off, but already the Sow being popped off here by a lone druid. Didn't get himself out of the Alban form, so not getting the full effect of the Sow. Or the full possible effect of the Sow. He might try and finish the job, but KSI is remaining in range of the tower. So if he needs to, he just hits recall on the bear, and the bear starts beating down on Loader. Loader just stares him down. It's like, there's a rat here. I know there's a rat here. Get up on the table, man. Get up on the table. Axe is in from Crazy. Cleans up the middle lane. And then S then moves forward. At the same time, Illidan's still free farming top lane. 44 for 10. SA is rotated out. So this is now Loader coming down for a kill. Doesn't get a kill. And, in fact, losing his hero on the bottom lane after RP's already been blown. And he's not getting farmed from the top lane. It's giving that space to Aki right now. A 10 minute rune. S4 just cannot catch a break. Down on bottom lane is a regeneration. And the movement's coming from Loader. Might be looking to snipe it off. Beastmaster's already making his run. Roar off cooldown in 5 seconds time. And Loader will see him. Pick up that regen rune. There it goes. And Loader, choice to initiate, he will not take. Decides against it. And then extra TPs, middle lane. Coming in from both sides. So Arsar, Sentry Wards, and Hello Loader, pick up! And it's attacked. I really don't think he was ready to see Loader then. Really don't think he was ready to see him. Threw down the Sentry Ward, and then just all of a sudden auto-attacked. And Crazy, looking for a Roar. He can get it on EGM. Almost. Nice tether up to the high ground. S4, good positioning too. Giving that option open to Wisp. So a smoke gank from Beastmaster ends up failing. And I'm still seeing a free farming lone druid on the bottom lane. Yep, phase boost, tranquil boots, which means we'll see the normal Maelstrom build. Top lane. Whoop, Illidan. Rage. All he needs to do. He's still got infest too. Infest it. RP. He needs to infest. And jumps back out again and gets the kill. Now in comes a Roar too. Admiral Bulldog needs to go down. And this is spiraling out of control for no tide. Loader can't find the space to do anything. He doesn't have a defusal blade. Look at his farm. He's walking around with power treads as well as an orb of venom. It's nothing. It's absolutely nothing. And while the bottom tier 1 tower is being beaten down by bears, Beastmaster will rotate back in towards the middle lane. And Aki will come to the bottom lane to defend, but he knows too, if he gets entangled, he's dead. KSI is up at level 10 already, with 1600. Buy that Mithril Harrow if he wants to, maybe go into a Basher. So many different options for him. Middle lane TPs are coming, they want to kill out in the Beastmaster. But Radiant side, really good warding. It's not 20 minutes in just yet, so I'm not checking for the wards of No Tide just yet. Even though Wisp does have level 6. They're not going to find that global ganking combo just yet. They're using S4 to run himself in. And then the tier 1 tower going on the top lane, which means Illidan, who's already got armlet as well as phase boots 12 minutes in. He's looking very, very good. But they're not stopping that tier 1 tower from going down the middle lane. Beastmaster, Axis, S4, if he wants to jump him, TP comes in on top of the tower. They are going to stop this tower from going down. It's just out of denial range. And S4 with his remaining mana, TP's himself back out. That had to be pretty damn close. He was out of mana at the end of that ulti jump, which he popped the TP scroll during the middle of. And now because he TP'd all the way back to base, to regen up, all Virtus Pro have to do is just move themselves up the mid. They've still got that roar available from Crazy, and the second that happens, Illidan already going to go for the open wounds, and Bears come in to help off. AGM still going to be very, very slow to Crazy. Can't find a target to roar, and the smoke already being blown out too. Coddle Blast, Axis, Dire have no creep wave, and with 5-man Dota from Virtus Pro, they can either go Roshan or then go in for a tier 2 tower. And KSI, as she said, screw it, let's go for a tier 1 tower on bottom lane. Let's take out all the added towers of no tide in 13 minutes. Exactly what they were searching for. Mech charge on the fly in, so that is going to be for Beastmaster? Beastmaster, the man with the buckler. I remember I was saying during the draft that VP could go for a full push in lineup, but that's not talking like TA heroes in the middle lane, but now you see just the effect that Beastmaster has. You look through his build-up, and you've got 4 points up in the inner beast, combining up already with what the lone druid brings to the table. And then they just beat through these towers. Cooldown comes, Illidan cops a little bit of damage, but he doesn't really care. They eat through the tier 1 tower, and keep pushing through the tier 2. Axis to fly, no need for a Coddle Blast. Just a Fade Bolt plus the Axis, just keep the Chakra up, and then go through a tier 2 tower. At the same time though, tier 1 tower was brought down the middle lane. Lowered S4, trying to force this out, but we know the Virtus Pro won't stop. There's no reason for them to stop. There's no way that Notai can push in a tier 3 tower where there is every way that Virtus Pro can. Bears the front lines, not everybody's back. Notai, look at the speed they're pushing. EGM's got to take Loader back right now. TP's got to come. The tier 3 tower's out of 1/3 of its life points. Notai is still caught on the back foot. Okay, now they're tethered up. I have to hold them in. The tower is gone. They're going for the Rax. We're 14 minutes in. The Rax exposed. Here comes S4. Goes for a pull-in on Crazy. And the Mag RP. Two to be caught out. Is that we're all going to come off? Yes, it does. Splits them up. Pushes S4 back a little bit. And the Nakes remain alive. The Bear remains alive. Gets entangled on Aki. Illidan's got a choice of who he wants. Just trying to push S4 away. Coddle Blast will kill off Aki. They might lose the Rubik, they might lose the Beastmaster, forced to buy it by the Gyro, but the Rax is still the main target. The Bears are on the front lines. It should be enough. Tethers are in. The Rax is gone. Now the fallback from VP. They took what they wanted. They forced buybacks. They get killed. Storm Spirit, long jump in, and he doesn't even stop KSI. He manages to TP out in time. There was no pull. Arsat also TPing out, and the Bear hit body blocks Loader out. Wonderful play from Virtus Pro. Wonderful play. And no Tidehunter. They had no answer to it. And they had no answer to it because their draft doesn't allow for it. It's too late in the timing. They got no counter push. They get an RP off. They still kill off two heroes. But the tank ability and the space and the farm that KSI got very early on is just too much. And he just said, screw it. Like, I got the cash. I'm going to go straight into Radiance. Normally when you see both Tranquil Boost and Phase Boost being bought up, you don't have enough money to then just go into a Radiance in an adequate amount of time. But because the amount of pushing, because they've taken a rank so early on, because they've taken down, how many towers? That's 5 towers. 3 tier 1s, 1 tier 2, 1 tier 3, and the racks on top of that. They've already got all the confidence in the world to pick up a relic up on that bear. I'll start with the cover fire. A quick seal from EGM, stole Shockwave. Got a blast, doesn't hit the creep wave though. But the Bear's tanking up the tower. No resum for KSI for another couple of seconds, so he's got to be careful with this one. Another Coddle Blast, Aaron Bulldog, not getting hit by this one. In fact, again, second air ball of the blast. You can see Stormwind jumping through behind. He's just up on that high ground, and there you go. Jumps himself in, looking for NS. Loaded here as well. Very quick initiation in on the Rubik. The Bear should go down Crazy as well. Never got that roar off. However, the Coddle Blast hit pretty hard there, and Aaron Bulldog, four staff down. And Arsar's able to run himself away, and now is S4 in with Illidan. Loader will pick up a triple kill through this, so he did manage to catch up to the Keeper of the Light. And then your RP, an ultra kill for Loader. Is this really happening? Oh, Illidan. He's going to deny the Rampage. He's inside the melee creep. And now he jumps off. He wants Admiral Bulldog. Quick pull in. He had to go into Rage instantly, and now he'll go Rage. Eating Loader. Big kill to take if he can claim it. But there goes your smoke. Armlet toggle. Quickly done. Admiral Bulldog will finish him off. So now VP get entirely team wiped. They push the tier 2 tower. Slight overconfidence. And no tie get thrown a very, very large bone. I guess 13 to 12. How much of an advantage did VP just throw away then? Sending about 7,000 gold advantage. Comes down by a decent mana and experience for, well, if you don't include that extra like 200, 300 or the 50 experience gain that was there for No Tide Hunter. Comes back the way of No Tide. 4k worth of experience, 5k thrown away. And now the Orchid is coming closer and closer to that, for that Stolen Spirit. And then Beastmaster, there will be no roars. KSI goes, whoop, I better get an Ultimate Form. Crazy. Worth the roar for this one. Do it right now. However, the support coming in is EGM and EGM Illidan. He wasn't ready for that. Lotus now going to get caught here too. Sentry wards go down. KSI is ticking over from the Urn Charge. But he's still in Ultimate Form, so he doesn't really care about that. He'll care if Mag tries to make a play though. Shockwave will miss. KSI continues to run away. NS can't get a pickup. He was looking for that Telekinesis. Couldn't grab the grab. And now four staff up on the keeper with the line. Of course, Arsad had that trying to escape before. But Lotus so quick on his feet. That Rikimaru. And you see him go for a different style of build now. This is the build he keeps going on his carries. Goes up for that Yasha first, and then goes into a Sanjay Yasha. Probably still would have wanted Diffuser Blade up on the Rikimaru, but I think he's realizing that it's not going to be enough. It's not going to be enough during these fights. So either he goes with a BKB, and then picks up the Sanjay Yasha, but I got a really funny feeling of Sanjay Yasha. Just because I've seen Loader do it multiple times in the past. But it could still be a BKB. But letting it up against an Entangle, plus a Beastmaster Roar. I suppose it's better that he takes it out as opposed to heroes like Mag. Admiral Bulldog still wants to get that Blink Dagger if he gets roared instantly. Then it's Arsad is out. It's Loader is able to just run himself around freely during the team fights unless he gets entangled. And that chance is high. Now tier 2 tower to be brought down. Aki. Already preparing for it. Very, very smart warning. And now it's 20 minutes in. So as I promised, let's check out the warning. Top lane push is coming, but this is just a new ward being put down, defensive ward, and then there is not a single ward on the other side of the map. In fact, there's one ward here, in this little position, and there's one ward here. That's no time under submission. That's not meant for a Wisp jump in. They've got to use other heroes to initiate. Or to scout out. Loader basically becomes a walking ward in that scenario. So tier 2 tower goes down, and this time no time won't find it. They're fighting from downhill to uphill unless they want to initiate into it. Nespor couldn't find a good snipe off position. If he found one hero that was just slightly away from the pack like he did last time, then it would be very, very different. But in this case, it's not the case. It's also, again, the case that EGM as well as Loader's on the other side of the map when this first push-in's coming. And the town's already under half of its life. Illidan rages, moves back. He's got Desolator up too. It's the negative armor already coming out in the tower. And looks like VP going to fall back. Not going to force it. Illidan's here, because they do have Keeper of the Light. And look at that damage to EGM. Four hits and he's gone. And now Loader must move back. Keeper of the Light doesn't have ulti for another 30 seconds. But in 30 seconds time, they'll just push in through the top. All Illidan's going to do is just keep forcing out that bottom lane. But you saw how fast that Wisp just melts. Loader. He'll need support if he wants this. Wow, Storm Spirit, that's a long jump down for Arsad. But gets the pull and does the damage. Same time, Bears arrive. And he moves back. So good snipe off. It's a long jump, cost him all of his mana, will force him to walk all the way back to base again. But still, it's a snipe off. So they lose the Keeper of Life from the top lane, and that kind of stops the pushing as well. Like, if you're looking at the timing, you see Illidan push out that bottom lane. And then for VP to then go in through the top after the bottom lane had the momentum. They need a Coddle to pull him up. Piccolo goes down and VP fall back a little bit. But then they also group themselves up around the secret shop. S4's in the neighborhood. Jump up. There's an Orchid on this one. But he can't find the opening. All he could find is bears. And VP, are they gonna finish up the bottom lane? Still arranged racks down here. Better land to come in through as far as like team fighting goes until this just happened. It's a blink dagger for Mag. This is unknown to VP. They could find themselves in a really hairy position. Especially if they start doing this. If Roshan doesn't go down in like 10 seconds, then VP are in a lot of trouble. Load up. Yeah, the ping's already coming out. They know what's going on. In comes smoke, in comes TPs, and then the Storm Spirit. Already with Static Remnant. They can see up in the high ground. There's your RP! Big hit, but RP stolen! Now can be returned! Admiral Bulldog held in position, so KSI can turn and fight! Admiral Bulldog and S4, the Fable will fly through them both! It's a double kill for Ren S. Crazy being stunned up by Roshan, buyback by Lone Druid, buyback by the next. Coral Blast will fly, it's a damage to EGM. Instantly pulled back in by the Keeper of the Light and the Old, but they'll go back in for Roshan. Crazy still here. And there's KSI coming back to the fight, running himself in. Roshan taken, 3 euros on the sideline. So VP have forced them 2 buybacks, but they still take the fight and they will finish up that bottom racks. Narutai don't have enough to stop them. Especially now that RP is down. And it could just be a rotation into mid after they take this racks. See KSI already making that move over. Makes for a quick jump for the bear. And Illidan will beat down the tower as well. Fortification forced out by No Tide. Storm Spirit coming up in 1 second time. Do VP stay or do they go? EGM Spirit's being tanked up by Illidan. Not to mention he's taking up the tower. Admiral Baldock could just blink and skewer, but not going to happen. Roar on cooldown as well. Probably another bit of an influencing decision. But what an RP by NS. Very much deserved double kill for him. He did wait in that Fade Bolt perfectly too to take the double kill. But it was no tie jumping in. They had the advantage. If that RP wasn't stolen, that was a full fight their way as well as Roshan. That's a guarantee for that. Because the timing basically was there. KSI still went down, but he turned to do some kind of damage. And Nakes had, well, obviously he bought back and keep the light got more space as well to move himself into a better position. So then the buybacks pull out. Oh, the line's been drawn. They want to go in through the bottom. But is there sentry wards? There's an observer ward, not a sentry. Now look for the one here on the bottom lane. And who can they find? I'm seeing Aki. Beastmaster Roar. Or do they just use open wounds? Open wounds. Go Scepter quickly, but the Coddle Blast is also going to fly in a moment. And that Radiant Spurn is still having its effect. And Aki, now he gets beaten down. S4, Infest damage hurts him too. Bear the front lines. Loader jumps in. Smoke screen got to come up, but now Loader's entangled. And the Coddle Blast flies over. Gets a double kill. It picked up Loader on the front of it. And then Bulldog on the rear end of it. And then the buyback from Loader. Move in, back to that mid tower. VP know their objective. They want a secondary racks. Loader jumps in, he tries to go on NS. 4 staffs away, however. Gets him out of the smoke, but Illidan being locked in. Coddle Blast will fly, now he turns around, starts life leeching. Loader to go down, and that'll be GG. That'll be a secondary racks. 24-15. The Aegis will pop at the end of the day, so it didn't even matter if Nakes went down when Loader initiated on him then. That's a very solid game from Virtus Pro. Carrying the advantage basically the entire way through as far as gold goes, as far as map control goes. The fact that 14 minutes in, they basically entered the base and Notai did not find the trade. They did not find the usefulness out of the SA in time. And this means game 2 goes to Virtus Pro. And game 3 coming up in a couple of moments time. Winner will face up against Team Dignitas. That will be the final game of the night, and also the final game before for actually like 3 days. There'll be no Dota 2 coming off from Monday, Tuesday, or Wednesday. I will be doing something on Monday night, appearing on a talk show on Monday evening, and there. After that, we'll be having. I believe I'm probably going to do a Company of Heroes stream on Tuesday evening, but on Wednesday morning I fly to Kiev. And then Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday It will be a pure Star Ladder Grand Final. So hopefully you'll join me for that one too, guys. But for the meantime, have a bit of a break, grab yourself a Kit Kat, and we'll be back here in a couple of moments' time with game number 3, the final deciding matchup of No Tide versus Virtus Pro.